Hello everybody. And welcome to Univ English Channel. It's all my pleasure to meet you again in this series of e-learning lectures, aimed at developing your knowledge and skills in the area of didactics and pedagogy, to reach teaching learning quality. This is lecture number 13. Learning Styles. By the end of this lecture, learners will be able to define the meaning of learning styles. Determine the importance of learning styles. List the important learning styles model. Identify the components of learning styles. But, before we move forwards, if you have not been here before, then, welcome to Univ English Channel. If you do like videos like this, then make sure to hit the subscribe button. And also smash the notification bell to receive notifications of when I produce more videos like this. For more information, you are invited to visit my website, englishmokerma.com. It's all about didactics and ESP lectures. So, let's begin with this question. What do you think about learning styles model? Introduction. Learning styles vary from student to student. It describes how they approach learning. Individuals have their own preferred methods of absorbing, processing, comprehending, and retaining information. Learning style describes the way a learner perceives, processes, and makes sense of new information, usually through sight, touch, and sound when attempting to consolidate particular ideas. Accordingly, different learning styles lead to different learning outcomes. Definition. James and Gardner, 1995, shed light on the learning conditions in their definition of learning style. Learning style is a complex manner in which, and conditions under which, learners most efficiently and most effectively perceive, process, store, and recall what they are attempting to learn. Hartley, 1998, states that, learning styles are the ways in which individuals characteristically approach different learning tasks. Saracen, 1998 claims that, learning style is the preference or predisposition of an individual to perceive and process information in a particular way or combination of ways. Omrod, 2008 page 160, maintains that some cognitive styles and dispositions do seem to influence how and what students learn. Some students seem to learn better when information is presented through words, verbal learners, whereas others seem to learn better when it's presented through pictures, visual learners. Types of learning styles. The concept of learning styles began in the 1970s when academics and industry began positing that everyone learns in different ways. Several discussions were launched to highlight the importance of learning styles and preferences. Several theories emerged classifying people into visual, auditory, and tactile learners. Other theories outline different cognitive approaches people take when learning. There are different methods of learning, expressing, remembering and understanding new information. What are the four learning styles? In 1992, Fleming and Mills developed a new model for learning, which is referred to as the VARC learning style theory. The VARC model is used to understand how students learn. For instance, a student who is a visual learner may feel unengaged, confused, and frustrated when listening to a verbal lecture alone. Learning styles include visual, auditory, tactile, and kinesthetic. Visual learners. Research considers that visual learners tend to remember facts and details if the material is presented in graphical forms, such as arrows, charts, diagrams, or symbols. In the same way that designers emphasize specific design elements with visual hierarchy, visual learners thrive when they see clear pictures of information hierarchy. For visual learners, pictures, graphics, and images make it easier to organize and communicate their ideas, and flashcards are the most effective learning tool. The visual learner makes sense of new concepts through visual aids, so diagrams, flowcharts, pictures, and symbols can be helpful to develop new skills. It will be very difficult for visual learners to stay focused during a long lecture that neglects visual components. For visual learners, Working with pictures is often much easier than working with words because it is much easier to picture what you are recalling while thinking of it. It is much more difficult to recall a word. As another way to help visual learners, you may wish to consider rearranging your page in a way that is more descriptive of the relationship being described, such as writing the words in a circular pattern if that more accurately represents the relationship you are describing. Color coding notes can also be helpful to create a more stimulating visual environment. Visual learning is implemented through diagrams, flowcharts, pictures. Rewrite words with symbols and initials. Use colors and underline important concepts. Auditory learners. Listening, talking, memorizing, and debating are preferred methods of learning for auditory learners. Auditory learners find audiobooks more helpful than printed books. Listening is the method of learning for audio learners. This means that attending lectures, tutorials, and group discussions is crucial for these learners. Read your texts out loud if you are an auditory learner, so you can hear how the words sound. Organizing group discussions about course ideas and topics can also be beneficial. Take notes during lectures with plenty of extra space, and return to these notes after discussing the material in further detail. Add new information. Auditory learning is based on focus on reading text aloud and pay attention to speaker's tone. Record and summarize on tape and listen to them later. Discuss the new taught concepts with learners. Reading and writing learners. Touch and movement are the best ways for tactile learners to learn. They often participate in demonstrations, write, or build models. Read/write learners are mainly interested in reading and writing strategies. These types of learners are generally well suited to university-style courses, lots of books and study notes in which to immerse themselves. If you are a reader/writer, pay attention to course glossaries. As they progress through the course, they may create their own glossary. Also, they are invited to review their notes after lectures, review them again, and create a new, streamlined set of notes. Additionally, lists can be an extremely useful learning tool. It is a good idea for all students to rewrite explanations and notes to fit their own style. Defining or describing a concept in your own words is the best way to find out if you do not understand some portion of it. Read and write learning is related to textbooks, glossaries, and rewriting notes in different words. Use lists and rearrange to align with the target goals. Reread and rewrite textbook and lecture to acquire new skills. Kinesthetic learners. Kinesthetic learners are more likely to communicate with their whole body, they demonstrate ideas through gestures, and they learn best through hands-on experience. Learning through doing is a way of life for kinesthetic learners. For university students, this is a challenging style of learning because lectures do not always provide opportunities for hands-on learning. Thus, labs and tutorials become even more necessary for these learners. Learners are asked to include all of your senses in studying. The more they incorporate them into their experience, the easier it will be for them to recall. Kinesthetic learners can increase the usefulness of their notes by providing several examples of each concept. They may take a case study from the book, or lecture, or lab, and then try to create their own. Generally, the more personal their example is, the more likely they are to remember and describe the new concepts. They are intended to practice as much as they can by taking tests and practice questions. Kinesthetic learning incorporates all human senses. Examples are included in two notes. Attending labs and tutorials. Practice tests and questions to support knowledge. Conclusion. The concept of learning styles describes the fact that people learn information in different ways. Learning styles have been gaining popularity within the last several decades. Educators at all levels of education have shown an intense interest in learning styles. Further, the learning styles model appears to be widely accepted within the general public as well as among educators. Despite the fact that the learning preferences do not change very often, learning environment can influence how we develop your skills. For instance, perhaps after several years at university, you begin to realize you are a more read/write person than you were in high school. New study strategies are not easy to implement right away, and it takes practice and time for new habits to be formed. You may discover that your time spent on a new study technique is taking up too much of your time, and you feel that you could spend that time more productively. Developing new habits takes time, and as your progress continues, it will become easier and less of a burden.